Maybe your skin does too. Introducing New Pond's Hydro Nourishing Formula, 2-in-1 daily moisturizing care for your skin.
Pepsi can or what?
Introducing a whole new way to look at Pepsi and Diet Pepsi.
It's beautiful.
Here we go. Don't know what I'm getting so excited about. I mean, it'll only be once round the block. I'm longing to go. Oh, no, women. More embarrassment when he doesn't clear up after me.
Yuck.
Well, well, well. I might get him trained after all. Fancy a bit of a walk? Oh,
Sunday Mystery at 7:15, Murder, She Wrote, starring Angela Lansbury, and yet another perplexing case.
Jessica, I swear I did not kill Martin Bergman.
The guy should have never been let out in the street again.
Something is missing.
There always is in this type of show.
Now, there's something wrong. I know it.
Oh, very good. But look out behind you.
Val threatened to kill Bergman.
Sergeant, that was 7 years ago.
Wrong, Mrs. Fletcher.
Murder, She Wrote, Sunday Mystery at 7:15. Say the wrong thing in this country, and you could be sleeping with the fishes.
Manjus.
Yeah, point taken, Don. I have you. A murder.
I really think I could live here.
Grazie, Signor.
Well done, woman. He's got me down for an idiot.
I think you're getting hot under your collar.
An Englishman, madam, never gets hot under anything.
The Politics of Pasta. Route into Europe. Sunday at 8:45 on Central.
Now on Central, a desperate mother, an abandoned baby, a small dance.
Donna.
Hello.
All right, are you?
Yeah. You?
Yeah.
Just looking. Some hope.
I got a job. Start the end of the month.
That's good.
Our mate works here. Car auctions.
Oh, yeah.
Washing the cars and that. Just looking to see if there's anything better. We're going down the chip. Are you coming?
With my mum and dad. Better get back. I'll walk with you, though.
Nothing then?
Couple of things. Packing and, I don't know, checking or something at King's Lynn.
You can forget them then.
They were only part-time anyway. Weren't nothing else.
You're all right as you are for a bit. You got the lay-by and your mother's flowers. Won't be long and the factory will have something for you.
Bound to be something.
Even if it's only casual.
I don't mind catching the bus.
Not to King's Lynn, you won't. You've seen them hanging around the bus stops of a morning. Spending all the wages on bus fares and canteen dinners and that.
I could take a pack up.
Oh, yeah? And spend an hour a day on some bus with the lads from the cafe? No, you're not. There's an end of it.
I was spoiled, and then I turned you against it. And then it was all my fault.
Is it? Coronation Street in Brookside. Tea?
Best be off. You okay walking?
Until 10, is it?
If there's an extra half hour going, I'll take it. Remember and take my telly.
Two, please. Then the double ones. Pound, is it?
Mm-hmm.
What's so interesting out there, then?
Nothing.
Well, don't make your mother have to shout you every bloody night, eh?
No, Dad.
Have you been to the factory today?
Last time they said they'd send a message with Mum. Told me not to keep on going.
And I'm telling you to get yourself over there. All right?
Yes, Dad. King's Lynn was advertising for Packers last night.
King's Lynn's too far away, I keep telling you. All your time and money used up on bus fares.
They got a coach.
I said no. God, why does she keep going on about it?
Your dad said no, Donna.
I've seen them King's Lynn girls on that coach. I won't have you on it.
Their dads might not care, but yours does.
At least we know what goes on up the road.
Leanne Edwards goes.
I don't want to let you!
Leanne Ed was pregnant again. Second abortion this past 2 years, that'll be.
My bloody abortioner. She'd not need it a second time. I'm off for a bath and then out.
I was just stretching my legs.
I thought you wanted your flowers.
What have you got?
Next. In a couple of months, it'll only be chrysanthemums. Then a couple of months later, and the season will be over.
I'll miss stopping off.
Have to get them from the market.
Yep. Come on, then. Come for a ride. Come on. You get cold out there.
Like a new purse.
Put your belt on, there's a good girl. Where shall we go? Must be somewhere around here. Somewhere quiet.
Up here.
Good girl. No one will come down here.
No. They finished these fields. Cartridges are empty.
Don't do that.
What?
Come on, then.
I don't know.
Why we're here, isn't it? Don't be silly.
give me a hard time, not now. Come on, be a good girl. Take it off. Take it off.
Polly, put the kettle on, we'll all have tea.
It's on.
What's your mum doing?
Pricking out the lettuces.
The boss said left some packing for you next week. Lettuces, tail end of the daffs. Just a couple of shifts, but that'll put a bit in the kitty till the factory takes you on.
Cup of this.
They're nice cars, aren't they, Dad?
Lovely. I'm gonna buy us one then.
Going out then, Bri?
Can't sit round here all day.
A new Cavalier GSI 2000 with the option of four-wheel drive. It's very good in the wet. Vauxhall. Once driven, forever smitten.
How's that then?
Hey! This is a pitching floor. Not a racetrack. Mind you, I need a racing start if I'm to get
it clean by then. Might as well have that film on now.
Queen, look at her.
There she comes.
Watch her, watch her.
Having a laugh, are you?
Something funny, is it? Well, I'm not laughing.
Stand there admiring me.
I made a cup of tea.
I'll be in then.
Who cares if you can't have that Italian designer dress because of your passion for Italian food?
Ooh.
Who cares if your good intentions go to pot because you can't resist desserts? Who cares if popping out for a sandwich means piling on the calories? Who cares enough to come up with shapers, calorie-counted foods that taste anything but? Who cares?
Smallest off license.
Yes, this is it.
You haven't any Tennent's pills now, have you?
Brewed with Czechoslovakian yeast.
Yeah, to taste a bit different.
Be careful. These are the last two.
Don't worry, we'll keep it under our hats.
Is someone pulling your pilsner?
At times you feel thirsty. So does your skin. Sometimes you might feel like something more. Maybe your skin does too. Introducing new Pond's Hydro Nourishing Formula. 2-in-1 daily moisturizing care for your skin.
Fortunately for home buyers in this region, there is a rather special building society that concentrates on helping them every minute of every working day. A building society which, in its long history, has never forgotten what a building society should do. Provide the best possible service to home buyers and home owners. The Derbyshire. Home in on our strength.
Send your films away to TruePrint, and in return, TruePrint will send you superb prints. Plus, a free film every time. So whatever else happens, you can trust TruePrint.
BP's research and testing tends to leave an impression on most visitors.
Fourth floor aviation fuel research. Sixth floor marine lubricants testing.
And we put this research to use in a very practical place. Your local BP station.
Pizza for Ted King?
Top floor.
Top floor space research.
BP on the move.
Only at Asda can you save 50p on a deep pan pepperoni pizza, 79p on 4 litres of orange juice. Get 4 cans of Asda Lager free with every 5 litres of Dulux White Emulsion. And buy George t-shirts from only £5.50 for two. The only at Asda promotion, now on.
Anyone ever miss you?
Dad's out. Mum's at work. No one else except the dog. What?
Mum and Dad.
What?
Nothing. How old are you?
16. How old are you then?
You don't want to know.
I've got a place for you. Start at 8 tomorrow.
The factory?
Yeah, the factory. Where'd you think?
What will I be doing?
On the line, I expect. It's not permanent, so watch yourself. Make sure they pick you if there's any proper jobs coming up.
My dear, join the family business, are you?
Come along with us, then.
You won't have a card yet. You come in with us. We'll sort you out. Handy for you, eh? 5 minute walk and you're here.
Don't suppose your dad'll be dropping you all that often. Have to get used to walking.
He might.
What, when Sandra has to walk every night, whether it's wet or dark or what?
Nice of him to give her a lift today. It being special and that.
Right, this is it then. I want you to wait here. And Mary will come and show you what to do. Just watch the other girls, you'll soon be as quick as them.
There she comes, the worker.
Hello.
You get on okay then. When's your first payday?
They never said.
Week in hand. She get paid Friday week.
There you are then. Keep you going. Okay.
Yes, thanks.
What line you go on?
Cabbages.
Was there a lot waiting?
I don't know.
Bet there is. I'll try and get overtime.
Long time no see. Where to tonight, young lady?
The barn. Where else?
Funny. I like to hear the music right through to the end. What time is it?
Nearly 11.
You'd better be back directly.
Mum?
What?
What did I want to be when I was little?
Oh, you know. A nurse or something. Why? Or married? I don't know what you wanted to be. I'll go and check them chickens are locked up.
I'll drive you back, shall I?
I'll walk.
I've got to go that way anyway.
I want to walk.
Up to you.
Who'd you buy your flowers for?
Sorry?
Who'd you buy your fl... You won't be stopping again.
What?
You won't be stopping again. I'm pregnant.
Why shouldn't I be?
I like your leggings.
Oh, do you fancy Chaz? Only if you do, I think he fancies you.
Does he?
Says so.
You going into King's Lynn?
There's your dad.
Right. Bye.
Bye.
What are you doing with that lot?
Just talking.
You don't hang around with them of a Saturday afternoon. You didn't think you was going into King's Lynn, did you?
Thought I might.
What for?
Just to look around.
Nothing to see you haven't seen before. What's the matter? Pay burn the hole in your pocket? Did you go in the cafe?
No.
Don't you hanging around in there with all the rest of them.
I wasn't.
Everybody knows what they get up to.
What? Just wanted to do something different for once. Get a bus into King's Lynn for a change. Don't you ever want to do something, Dad? Something...
You got a steady job, a good home. You don't need to go off every 5 minutes like the rest of them.
You don't stop in.
And what's that got to do with you? What you been hearing at that gossip bloody factory then?
Nothing. Nothing, Dad.
Good. What I do is my business, not yours. But what you do, you and your mother, that's my business.
I just want...
You want to be talked about at the pub like that bloody Leanna's, do you? You want to be easy meat for the lads, do you? If I ever hear your name at that pub or anywhere else, I'll bloody kill you. Get it?
Blaze! Blaze, come on, Blaze!
For?
He doesn't wear it anymore.
It's gone all baggy.
That's why I like it, Mum. All the thing now, baggy sweaters. I'll do the chickens.
I don't know what you look like.
Oh, leave her. Remember you and your beehive, do you?
It didn't look like Wurzel Gummidge.
As I remember it, you was in short socks and school uniform till I got my hands on you.
I was not.
And I was a big bird cradle snatcher. See you later.
He looks just like he did then.
Dad does.
best looking lad for miles.
You must have been good looking too.
Hmm?
For Dad to fancy you.
Oh, yeah.
Where'd you meet?
I don't know. The market. I was helping your granddad. And he was there with his lorry.
And?
They were all soft on him, the girls. He looked like Tom Jones. Used to call him Tomo. He didn't care about them. He saw me with your granddad and he went for me.
Why?
What do you mean, why?
Well, because you're with your dad.
I suppose so. He knew I never dated any of the local boys. Knew my family was strict. And he liked that. He still likes that.
So he moved down here?
Look at that. Football pushed in instead of the bill.
What would he have done if you'd got pregnant? Would he have walked out on you?
He didn't get me pregnant.
No, but...
Your father's a man like any other. What's all this for?
Nothing.
You got a bloke, have you?
No.
If you have...
I haven't.
You better not misbehave yourself.
Mum, I haven't got a bloke.
Well, when you do, then...
Seen enough girls?
You'll have to bring your health card in tomorrow for your medical.
What medical?
Everyone's got to have a medical. You should have had it when you started, but you're only casual then, weren't you?
Only casual now.
Been here 3 months now. That takes you off the casual list. Be about 10 tomorrow. I'll come and give you a shout when it's your turn, all right?
Going in tomorrow if it ain't any better.
He's come very sudden.
You could pick me pay up.
What is it then? Stomach, is it?
Period, ma'am.
Hmm.
I told you.
You never said it was there.
Not with Dad there, no. It's really bad this time.
You'll be better when you've had a family. I was.
Thank you.
Night.
Just so hot in there, isn't it? Smell of all that food and stuff.
Christ, don't moan about it. One time they give us something, eh? You got a comb?
Yeah.
Take it off.
Oh, no.
Go on. You're the only one wearing an overall. Christ, it is meant to be a party.
I'm gonna go home anyway.
You want a bit of fun, you do. You're a long time dead. A couple of years from now, you'll be like this. Be too bloody late then.
Going to the loo.
Football fans, yes, this really is the official England soccer squad for the official European Championships.
And this is the team's official snack food, your one and only Mars bar.
But just what makes Mars taste so special?
Well, cue the ingredient sequence. Is it the milk, the glucose, the malt, or the thick, thick chocolate?
Whatever it is, it's obviously going down very well with the fellas here. And when they get to Sweden, they'll be brimming, not to say chock full of confidence. Chris Wood, are you a fan of alternative comedy?
I can take it or leave it, done.
Who says footballers can't ad-lib? On to Europe, England, or as they say in Sweden, skaboodle, poodle, 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 poodle.
Mrs. Jenkins, it's Roger Lewis of BT here. I was just ringing to see...
Oh, hang on a second. There's someone else trying to get through. Hello?
Helen, we were just leaving and I suddenly thought, it is 7.30, isn't it?
No. No, it's 8.30.
All right.
No, I've got to go. I'll see you then. I'm sorry, you were saying?
All it was to check if you were finding...
Sorry, there's someone else trying to get through. Hello?
Hello, me again. I did tell you we've become vegetarians, didn't I?
Yes. Yes, you did.
Oh, good. Bye.
Oh, look, I'm really sorry.
Well, that's okay. I was only ringing to see if you were finding your new call waiting service useful.
For a free trial and availability, call 0800 800 821.
Question.
If I have some money left over in my current account each month, is it too much to expect it to earn decent interest?
If you want a current account that works like a savings account, meet the Midland, the listening bank.
Evening.
Do you want bacon and eggs?
Bacon and eggs?
Seeing as it's Boxing Day.
Go on then.
Where'd you get to yesterday afternoon?
Walking off my dinner with Blaze. Mum, give me a shout when the machine's going on. I got some muck on my anorak.
Waste of time giving you nice clothes. You've turned into a right little tomboy, you have.
Worst things to be.
Can't do any wrong, certainly, can she?
Jerry Dawes says she's the best little worker he's ever had. A good, quiet girl, he said.
Oh, Dorry, look at his eyes.
They'll break through hearts, they will. He's been here before, he has.
Look at his little arm.
He's got such a grip.
That's a good sign. Hold on to life, he will. Grab at things a bit.
Never knew a man who didn't.
Did it hurt?
What? Having him, did it hurt?
Don't ask me. He was worth it, I know.
How long did it take?
A bit longer than it took to get him in the first place.
This is what I got with the collection.
Hey, we got another 5 minutes yet, gal.
Thank you.
To get this all.
And a few million others with two to get. They're a fiddle, these things, I keep telling you.
You're turning into a right little stopping bed, you are.
Nothing to do over Sunday.
Give me a hand, then.
What with?
I said I'd go in for a few hours. There's leaks to pull, and the tractors need food, and you can hose them down.
Oh, Dad.
Please yourself. Any more tea? Thank you.
No, I can't help you. No.
Hello?
It's my daughter, Donna.
Hello, Donna. I was just telling your mother a baby's been found.
A baby?
At the petrol station.
Long line.
What sort of baby?
What do you mean?
Big, little, boy, girl.
What's the matter?
A newborn girl. We're looking for the mother.
Call her that.
I don't know anyone expecting round here. Do you, Mum?
It needn't be anyone obviously pregnant.
Where was it?
Long Lane Garage.
Be someone driving through then.
Maybe. So you can't think of anyone at all?
No.
Well then, you've heard. What do they want?
If we knew anyone pregnant.
Well, be a passer through, wouldn't it? Over there, bloody Leanne.
I never thought about Leanne. I was going to do cheese sauce. She put it right out of my head.
You should hear them buggers going on about it. That's all you can hear in the public. White as a sheet, old Wilson was, could get out of their bar quick enough to check on his three girls. First time he's looked to them in years, bloody old hypocrite.
Check his girlfriend, he should. That Mary woman up Dyke Lane.
Their faces. I told him, you want to be a father all the time, not when you're fine and pleased to. I said to him, serves you bloody right if it is one of yours.
Well, I hope they find her, I do.
Why?
Stop her having any more. Bloody steriliser, they should.
That's right, have done.
Come on, Donna. We got a clock on, then we got a few minutes off this morning.
Why?
Police won't have a talk to us. Be about that Bobby, you'll see. Poor little mite.
We've been making inquiries into the search for the mother of the abandoned baby at Long Lane service station. Now, if any of you knows, or suspect that you know, who this woman or girl might be, then please come up to us afterwards. If you feel you can't do that, then please give us a call. No one wants to get to do it. Make her life more difficult than it already is.
He can speak for himself.
We just want to help her.
How is the baby?
Still a little poorly. She was very cold after all, and she is, the doctors think, a few weeks premature. But on the whole, she's okay.
No thanks to the so-called mother. Such a woman like that don't deserve to have no baby.
That's right.
Thank you.
Right now, let's get started.
Tonight, the search continues for the mother of a baby abandoned at Long Lane service station on the A10. The baby is under observation in King's Lynn Hospital and is reported to be improving. Nurses have christened the baby Rose after the cashier who found her at the garage. However, after 2 days of it,
you just missed seeing Long Lane. They still have no the garage and everything. If I'd known, I'd have taped it.
Other headlines.
Fancy calling the poor little bugger after Rose Clark.
Local opposition groups have successfully persuaded Wisbeach Council.
How does your old dad grab you then? Smart enough? Turn a few heads, would I?
Depends if they're easy, please.
Getting witty, aren't we? You youngsters wouldn't recognise a real man if one come up and give you a kiss, eh? You want to watch that look of yours? You're not too old for a smart clout.
Thought you might take Mum.
You what?
You never even took her out on her birthday.
I'll take her when I'm ready to, not that it has anything to do with you.
She's stuck in all the time and you're out enjoying yourself.
Remember EastEnders? Rewind it.
It's done.
Looks like the poor little bugger's gonna die then.
What?
That babe. Poor thing.
What's wrong with it?
The police was back. Incubator it's in now. Donna? Are you warm enough, love?
Is she dying?
I haven't heard anything about her being ill. But we might not...
Will he have to know? My dad? Yeah. I just want to see her.
Garden Festival Wales. Ring Ebervale 350 360.
Created by Laboratoire Garnier, Paris. New Ombre Solaire Multi-Protective Formula. Protection against UVB protects against sun burning. Protection against UVA protects against sun aging. And it's water resistant. It actively moisturizes your skin. Ombre Solaire New Multi-Protective Formula. Because you love the sun and value your skin. Formulated and controlled by Laboratoire Garnier, Paris.
Colin has no common sense. So when he tried to reduce his cholesterol, things didn't go well. Silly, really. Had he any common sense, he'd try things like a low-fat diet with perhaps some oat bran. They could help reduce his cholesterol. Try some common sense. Oat bran flakes from Kellogg's.
Even when you've broken down and you're afraid to leave the car. Even when it seems there's no one who'll stop to help. Even when it's miles from anywhere and your passenger can't make the walk. We're all you need to know. AA CallSafe. Now you're just a fingertip away from the emergency services.
Hello, AA.
Or a very nice man. AA CallSafe. We're all you need to know.
Why are Skittles packets bigger? Because there's more in them.
That's why we like electric showers, don't we? Spontaneous, that's what we like.
Yeah, I'm all muddy and scampering around, and Mum goes, get in that shower, so goes, oh yeah, shower. Meow, straight upstairs and into the shower.
Yeah, well, what I like about it, especially in summer, is that it's quick and you save money. You don't have to put the heating on.
Brilliant. What they can do with technology today.
For all your creature comforts, shower electric.
Could you get Donna a hot drink? It's a machine, I'm afraid. Do you like hot chocolate? Thanks very much. Come and sit down then, Donna. Now then, Donna.
I want to see her.
You will soon, don't worry. Let's get you organised first, shall we? Get some details down.
I want to see her. I don't want to talk. They said I could see her.
Hello. I'm Peggy Fox, the duty officer. I'm a social worker. And you are Donna. It's not very cozy, is it?
Dr. Ford's been called away. He'll get back when he can.
Would you like to see the baby properly?
What's wrong with her?
A tiny touch of jaundice. We popped her under the lights.
They said she was ill.
She's a little underweight.
Said she was going to die.
She won't die, Donna.
We didn't know what to call her, so...
Sarah. Her name's Sarah. I can't go home. I'll take the baby back then, shall I?
I'd like to have a few words with Donna, actually, if I may. Could you leave Sarah with us? 10 minutes?
Morning. How did we sleep then? Like a little log. Oh, another dead one. No pulse, no temperature, and you're not breathing. No wonder you haven't got much to say for yourself. Oh, flaming nights. All they do is read Catherine Cookson and make toast.
To you?
Me? 19. Why?
I don't know.
Want some grub? Okay.
I'll get her fed. Can I help? Ooh, they'll be serving breakfast now. Better get yours before you're too late.
So?
We had to inform you.
Thanks.
Would you like to know which ward she's in?
No.
I wonder if I could have a word with your wife.
Do you want to have a word with them, Sand?
Mr. Matkin.
What?
You must want to know how they are.
I know what they are.
Your daughter hasn't got any clean clothes with her. Do you think we could have a few things?
If she wants anything, she can come and get it, tell her.
That may be very difficult for her to do.
Well, that's up to her then, isn't it?
She's afraid of you, Mr. Matkin.
Well, it's just a pity she wasn't a bit more bloody afraid then, isn't it? Perhaps if she had been, she wouldn't be where she is now.
They won't let me feed her.
They will.
They don't want me to have her.
Who doesn't?
People. People at the factory. My mum.
Oh, it's nothing to do with them. They don't know what you've been through. They don't know how you feel now. What?
I don't know how I feel now.
Well, there you are then. No. Donna, we all accept that you're the mother.
I am. Who said I'm not?
No one. It's just something we had to consider. But the doctor's seen you and...
You're not going to let me have her.
We want to. But first, you've got to get to know her. Show us you can look after her.
Do they have to prove they can look after theirs, do they?
No.
The baby's well. She's putting on weight. You'll announce in 2 days.
When can she come out?
Leave hospital, you mean?
Donna, remember what we were saying about you and the baby getting used to each other?
Yeah, but if she's all right and I am, then...
We haven't found you anywhere to live yet. Haven't even started looking.
I could live here.
Sorry?
In King's Lynn.
Donna, before we do that, before we fix a day or even think...
Have you held her yet? You haven't even held her yet. Well, let's stop playing games. She won't even hold the child, and you're talking about where they'll live. I've got work to do. She doesn't know what it'll be like. The crying, waking up in the night, dirty nappies, no money. If you can cope with all that, I'll be the first to applaud. Okay?
Hello? All alone again? Haven't you got a nightie?
Didn't have time to get one.
I'll lend you one, won't scratch you to death. I'm Carmen. You're the missing mum, aren't you? Listen, love. That one out there's number 2. If I could tell you the times I felt like walking away from the other little sod. Mine's a boy again, trust me. The only woman in the house, mine. Gonna have it taken out if I don't get lucky third time. What's her name?
Sarah.
That's nice. Mine was gonna be Hannah. As tis, she's Joseph. I'll show you mine if you show me yours.
She doesn't look jaundiced. Said it was only mild. She's lovely. You're lovely, aren't you?
Hey, she's like you,
is she?
Been there an hour.
Really?
She's giving the baby a cuddle.
see.
I held a newborn lamb once. Didn't make me a sheep. No luck.
She's ever so hungry. She keeps on opening her mouth and grabbing at me. Then she just stops and screams her head off.
She's as stubborn as they come.
Here. Call it a day.
Like a real mum. Listen to her. Yeah, piglet sounded just like that.
Got look glam for the new daddies, haven't we? Only time I'll ever look like Dolly Parton anyway. Getting dolled up too, are you? Yeah. You the bitch that dumped her baby? I hope you drown.
Nice smelly stuff left in the office, Donna. May as well treat yourself. Well, she's not much older than you, but she's got parents she can talk to. Her boyfriend comes every day. She showed off to the whole world she was pregnant. You couldn't do that, could you? She's had it dead easy, hasn't she? She's given up nothing for her baby. You've given up everything for yours.
I have, haven't I?
You've told Sarah that she's more important than your mum and your dad and your job and your home. You could have just left her here and got on with your life, but you didn't.
She don't know that.
She knows.
I can't open it.
Oh, you want me to take the baby?
No, can you open it, please? Go on, then. Congratulations on the birth of your lovely little daughter. Love from Nicola. Nicola?
Oh, Staff Nurse Williams. You are honored.
Thank you.
about the menus again.
Do you live with your mum and dad?
Oh, you must be joking. Now, cereal and toast for brekkie or the whole greasy fry-up.
Toast.
Lunch. Chicken risotto, lamb casserole or a vegetable lasagna. Lamb's best.
Lamb. I hate the sodden town.
Apple pie, fruit mix or cheese and biscuits. Oh, Donna, don't do that. How would you like to be woken up in the middle of a lovely sleep? Poor little love.
Learn how to put that thing down soon. Otherwise she'll start growing out of you like another arm.
Here you are. I've got quite enough as it is.
You can't just leave them.
I can. Listen. That rat bag Di's leaving too. There won't be anyone left who knows who you are soon. Fresh start, eh?
I wish you weren't going.
So do I. Only rest I get. Must be why I keep doing it, eh?
You staying in then?
Looks like it.
It's all been arranged. There is a vacancy, and St. Anne's mother and baby home is very well known to us.
Has she seen it?
You know she hasn't. We're going to have a look round it tomorrow.
And how do you feel about this, Donna?
All right.
I think Donna will be very happy when she sees the place.
Pity she couldn't have seen it before this meeting.
Yes.
I like it.
Well, I'm sorry, Donna, but I don't think you're ready for it.
I am.
Sarah's 8 days old. You've only known her 5 days.
She's not leaving till the end of the week.
It's not fair on Donna what you're doing. You're only a kid yourself.
I'm all right.
There will be staff there.
Oh, come off it. She went 8 months knowing she was pregnant and didn't ask anyone for help. She went into labor out in a barn and didn't ask for help. She left the baby out in the open and still didn't ask for help. That was only 8 days ago. How do we know she'll ask for help now?
I will.
Have any of you talked to this girl? Have you? Do you know what sort of a life she led? She's never been to King's Lynn on her own. Did you know that? What do you suggest, Staff?
The foster family scheme.
No.
A couple who'll take you in as one of the family, Donna, just you and the baby, just for the first few weeks.
No! My dad would have made me have an abortion. This thing was happening to me and there weren't nothing I could do. Like it took over. I couldn't go to anyone like you said. And then I had her. And she didn't die. And I didn't die. And no one knew. Then I heard she was dying and I woke up. That's what it felt like. I'm her mum. I want to do things for her. Don't matter how hard they are, I'll do them. I will.
Duty now.
Right.
Hope everything goes okay for you.
Thanks.
She's a lovely baby.
What you said, you was right.
I didn't mean it against you.
No. They want us out of here, really. That's it. It's okay. I'll look after her.
Of course you will.
If you would like to speak to someone in confidence about a relationship or an unplanned pregnancy, do ring 0800 767 800. Calls are free and lines are open from 6pm to midnight tonight and 10am to 1pm tomorrow. And a special issue of Girl Talk, a lively magazine full of help and advice for young mothers, has been produced in association with British Gas. For a free copy, please write to Girl Talk, PO Box 1DH, London W1A 1DH.
In L.A. law, you can be guilty by association.
And we got nothing to be guilty of. Our love will climb any mountain near or far. We are
LA Law, Thursdays at 9 on Central.
Before news at 10, we've time for an extra programme. Next, a preview of the European Football Championship, now just 1 week away.
Five doors. Three doors. Performance. Quality. Turbo diesels. And to top it all off, a top that drops. Rover 200. It's everything you expect. And much, much more.
Your teeth are under constant attack from plaque. So are their foundations, your gums. Fortunately, there are lines of defense. Brushing with McLean's fights the plaque that causes tooth decay. It also helps protect your gums from disease. For healthy teeth and gums, attack plaque with McLean's.
How can we make Snickers even more satisfying? More chocolate? More caramel? Or maybe more peanuts? Snickers, now with more peanuts. More peanuts, more satisfaction.
To keep going as long as Duracell, how many times would you expect to replace ordinary SP batteries? Twice? Three times. In this continuous test, Duracell outlasts ordinary SP batteries by up to six times. Why settle for anything less? Duracell. No ordinary battery looks like it or lasts like it.
Number 86, an excellent choice, sir. Your starter, sir.
Eats, Carling Black Label.
Comfort now has a special non-drip cap to help stop dribbles. Well, at least on the bottle.
With the best choice of gas fires and cookers, an interest-free credit option, trade-in allowances and delivery and fitting, there's a great deal for you in the gas home.
Central opens its new season of athletics with the Pearl Assurance European Relays from Sheffield. The biggest names in British track events will be there, including Linford Christie, Colin Jackson, Peter Elliott, Tom McKean, and never last and certainly never least, Sally Gummer. That's the Pearl Assurance European Relays, starting at 8, Friday on Central.
News at 10 follows shortly here on Central after a preview of the European Football Championship.
Sega, supporters of ITV's coverage of the European Championship. The greatest game of all.
Hello there. This time next week, the European Football Championship will be off and running. The opening ceremony will have set the scene, and perhaps the opening match between Sweden and France will have set a very high standard the rest will have to emulate. Euro 92, and ITV are moving out there, lock, stock and greavesy. It's a rich man's world, all right. Nothing comes cheap in Sweden. But the surroundings are quite delightful, even though the stadia are on the small size. Quite a contrast to the glamour and grandeur of Italia 90. This is the Rosunda Stadium in Stockholm, where we'll be based a week tonight. And at £5 for a glass of beer, we could well be in for an early night as well. So who's going to win it? 4 years ago in Germany, Ruud Gullit lifted the Henri Delaunay Cup after inspiring Holland to a sequence of irresistible performances. Gullit's back, as is that other Dutch master, Marco van Basten.
Played a lovely early ball in towards van Basten. Oh! Tremendous goal by the Dutch striker, Marco van Basten!
In 1984, the French and Michel Platini were magnifique. Platini was top scorer in the final stages, 9 goals in 5 games. As manager now, he'll be looking for a similar return from Jean-Pierre Papin, the European Footballer of the Year, JPP, as he's known. Platini is the heart and soul of French football, an incomparable player and clearly an excellent manager. Let's hear from an old adversary with similar credentials. At international level, the most decorated European of them all, the one and only Kaiser France, Beckenbauer.
When he took over the responsibility for the French national team, from this moment on, the team goes strong and stronger. And for me, the French team is one of the favorites in this competition.
Well, England's match against France, which you'll be able to see live on ITV, should determine who finishes top in Group 1. That's if all goes according to plan. Graham Taylor's planning has seen considerable changes in personnel and strategy. But he went into tonight's final preparation match against Finland in Helsinki with his strongest available team, according to the man himself. The result, 2-1 England, the performance energetic but rather disjointed. David Platt with both England's goals, and both beautifully taken, it has to be said. But John Barnes hobbled away on crutches, a ruptured Achilles tendon, he's out of the championship. As for Andy Roxburgh and the Scots, well, they also finished their sequence of warm-up games tonight. Gary Newbon was in Norway to see how they got on.
The competitive Norwegians gave Scotland several anxious moments, both with heavy tackling and scoring chances. Luckily, the Scots survived both, and thanks to some good saves by Andy Gorham and poor finishing by Norway. Scotland's biggest scare, though, came in morning training when Pat Nevin injured an ankle, but he will recover in time for the tough championship opener with Holland. Ali McCoist and Brian McClare were sensibly withdrawn at half-time to start a rush of substitutes. Scotland treated this for what it was, a practice match.
Well, Scotland's opening game against Holland, another of our live ones. Let's be more specific. Here's precisely what we have lined up for you. Our first report from Sweden will be on Saturday when the Saint and Greavesy play host at Wembley for the England-Italy Schoolboy International. Live from Stockholm next Tuesday, a full preview on the eve of the tournament. That'll be a who's who of European football. Then on Wednesday, the opening ceremony, followed by Sweden against France, live only on ITV. Scotland playing in their first European Championship finals, well, they go straight in at the deep end against Holland. 2 days after that, it's England against France. And to conclude the first phase, the Scots against the CIS, and what will surely be the match of the tournament up to that stage, Holland versus Germany. Also on location in Sweden, Saint and Greavesy, reflecting both the serious and the offbeat aspects of these forthcoming European Championships. Now, what about the event itself? Well, there are 4 venues. Stockholm, Gothenburg, Malmo and Norrköping. 8 finalists playing in 2 groups of 4, the top 2 in each group comprising the semi-finalists. England are in Group 1 along with France, Denmark and Sweden, who as host nation will be expected to put up a pretty good show. The Scots are in Group 2. They play in Gothenburg and Norrköping. They start with the holders, finish with the runners-up of 4 years ago, and take on the world champions in between. Simple, really. Well, there you go. All we set out to do tonight, really, was to get you in the mood, to give you an idea or two as to what we have planned, and to introduce you to our Euro 92 theme tune. I'll see you next week. You are the
So you want to play at Power Games. Friday Blood Ties, 10:40 on Central.
You're watching Central, it's now 10 o'clock.
Says Britain presses ahead with the Maastricht Treaty. As Danes celebrate, the government here says no referendum. Chaos in Brussels, now the French will vote on the treaty. Rio summit opening told the earth is sick and in danger. And Dr. Devious wins the derby, Leicester's nowhere. Good evening. The Prime Minister said today he would push on with legislation to ratify the Maastricht Treaty on European Union, despite the no vote in Denmark. He rejected the idea of a referendum here. The government wants to consider the implications of the Danish vote. Because of that, MPs didn't begin today their line-by-line examination of the Maastricht deal as they'd planned. The parts of the treaty which technically fall because of Denmark's vote include moves towards a single European currency, extra powers for the European Parliament, and moves towards a common defence and foreign policy. Denmark's vote has thrown the EC into confusion, with many saying the treaty is now dead in the water. European foreign ministers meet in Oslo tomorrow to decide what to do.
Ministers were called to Downing Street this morning and confirmed what Douglas Hurd had said earlier, that while Britain still supported the Maastricht deal, they could not in practice ask the Commons to carry on working on a broken-backed treaty. Broken-backed at least for now, because the rules say that what was signed after Maastricht has no effect until the parliaments of all 12 member countries ratify it. If one does not, the treaty fails. Yet, as John Major greeting schoolchildren before leaving for the Commons today knows, give the European community a crisis and it can often fix up a deal to end it. And the message the Prime Minister brought to the Commons, understandable after his strenuous John or fix it efforts at Maastricht and later, was that the treaty is still worth fighting for.
The government continue to believe that the deal we secured at Maastricht is in the best interests of this country.
Some shouts of no at that.
In the expectation that Denmark will in due course be able to join them, our partners propose to complete the ratification procedures. We share that judgment and intend to continue with the passage of the bill.
But not just now, and Neil Kinnock said a delay was sensible.
Unless and until there is an agreement in the community that is capable of being implemented by the whole community, it would be somewhat unreal to debate an agreement which, for the time being, has been cast into doubt by the votes of the Danish people.
But Paddy Ashdown, aware that the EC's own polling recently showed plenty of support for Maastricht in Britain, wants a referendum, but he got a rough ride when he asked Mr. Major about it.
Does he, in that regard, accept that after this House does, as I hope it will, confirm the Maastricht process, the British people are entitled to have their say in a referendum, and that the cause of Europe has nothing to fear from that process?
Well, Mr. Major said no, there wouldn't be one. But from Paris today, a statement from Mrs. Thatcher praising the Danes for their, quote, great service for democracy against bureaucracy. That made clear her own undimmed enthusiasm for a referendum. And back at Westminster, other Eurosceptics, Tory and Labour, weren't hiding their delight at what the Danes have done.
And I can't believe that the Danish people's worry about Euro-federalism and Euro-centralism isn't shared here in Britain.
The treaty is dead, and the crucial thing is to get Parliament to accept it.
Well, Parliament didn't go that far today, and indeed, people like Sir Edward Heath flatly disagreed with the idea of the treaty being dead. But it was clear some Tory support for Mr. Major on Maastricht is weakening. Some earlier supporters now want it changed.
I was never terribly enthusiastic about the Maastricht Treaty in the first place, but I think John Major did a good job in amending it, which made it tolerable, but no more. But now I see a chance to rethink the whole treaty.
But others who voted yes last time will probably vote no in future, if it ever comes to a vote, which they rather doubt.
I would have thought that this bill has been virtually held beneath the waterline. It may disappear altogether.
To all that must be added the early day motion that some of the Tory Eurosceptics are said to be putting down. They're saying in that, look, let's just have a common market, a free trade area and nothing else. And about 60 Tories are said to be ready to sign that. And then there's talk of a group of about 12 junior ministers who are ready to go to John Major and said, look, we've had enough of all this Maastricht business and we're not prepared to go on supporting it. But on the other hand, Labour and the Liberal Democrats will probably continue to support the government's ideas on Maastricht, provided, of course, that something satisfactory can be worked out in Europe as a whole. And on that score, the Foreign Office tonight is massively downplaying the expectations of the meeting in Oslo tomorrow. They say that it's just not on to expect that one meeting of the foreign ministers with Mr. Hurd there tomorrow can sort everything out. Michael Brunson, News at 10, Westminster.
Other EC governments have been suggesting that the Danish vote against Maastricht needn't in itself change much. Portugal, which has the EC presidency until it passes to Britain at the end of the month, said the 11 should now go ahead without Denmark. The Danes say they want to renegotiate the treaty.
Commission President Jacques Delors, prime architect of the European Union, looked stunned. The Danes' view that he was trying to seize too much of their sovereignty came as a slap in the face.
Mesdames, Messieurs, comme vous pouvez l'imaginer,
Monsieur Delors warned that the Danish vote would have far-reaching consequences, but he said the Maastricht treaties were indispensable and urged the 11 other countries to ratify them. In the Brussels corridors, there was astonishment that just 50,000 Danish voters had the power to threaten decisions taken by governments representing 340 million Europeans. The Danish result has turned the spotlight back on the splits in Europe over Maastricht. The Danish cabinet, stunned by the unexpected rebuff, decided at a crisis meeting to seek changes to the treaty. Last night's narrow result gave some anti-Maastricht protesters the opportunity to celebrate, others the chance to vent their anger at the politicians who tried to push through the treaty. In part, the vote expressed the Danes' long-held fear of German domination of Europe.
Germany and the bigger European countries will completely smash all the small countries of Europe, and for this reason the Danish people voted no today.
This afternoon, emerging from his cabinet meeting, the Danish Prime Minister reaffirmed his commitment to the community.
We are not able to sign the Maastricht contract, but we certainly wish to stay in the EC as close to full members as possible.
But Portugal, which currently holds the presidency of the EC, insists the treaty should go ahead without Denmark. The Portuguese government said it was looking at the legal implications of the no vote, and Denmark might have to leave the EC altogether. Portugal's foreign minister saw no prospect of renegotiation.
What I can tell you from the contacts I have had so far is that there is a strong unanimity in the sense that the 11 should go ahead without any hesitation to fulfill the objectives that they have set out in Maastricht. Second feeling is that there is no room for renegotiating the treaty.
Ireland, which receives huge subsidies from the EC, is to go ahead with its referendum on Maastricht despite the destabilizing effect of Denmark's vote. Today, the Irish government warned people a no vote would have serious economic consequences for the country. But the issue is clouded by fears that Maastricht could legalize abortion in Ireland.
The whole architecture and movement towards European integration and development continues, with or without those who do not want to join them. We want to join them. I'm quite certain the Irish people want to join them, and that's why we're going ahead on June the 18th to give a resounding yes vote.
The support of Germany, one of the founding fathers of the community, is crucial to the future success of Maastricht. The realization that the Deutschmark would be replaced by a single currency has made approval of the treaty by Germany's Bundestag look less certain. The new German foreign minister was keen to stress cooperation with the Danes, however.
Die Bundesregierung bedauert den Ausgang dieses Referendums. Wir sind der Meinung, dass der Prozess zur europäischen Einigung in der Sache und auch im Zeitplan eingehalten werden sollte. Die Tür für Dänemark sollte geöffnet bleiben und wir sollten alles tun, um den Dänen zu helfen.
The public mood of European leaders is that the Maastricht treaties must not be derailed. But behind their air of confidence, there is real fear that the Danes have let the genie of anti-federalism out of the bottle and that the treaties on political and monetary union may not be easy to save. Geoffrey Archer, News at 10, Brussels.
President Mitterrand announced today that the French will get a referendum, a vote on the Maastricht Treaty, probably in the autumn. The treaty can't be adopted in France anyway until the constitution's changed, a matter being debated now. In France, as elsewhere in Europe, doubts about the treaty are beginning to surface openly.
Monsieur Mazot, s'il vous plaît.
Repeated interruptions to the French Prime Minister's statement to Parliament, but Mr. Berengovoy made no secret of his annoyance that the whole project of building Europe, as he put it, might be torpedoed by 48,000 Danes. But only this week he himself narrowly escaped becoming a victim of doubts about Europe among French MPs. He survived a no-confidence vote on reform of the community's farm policy by just 3 votes. And in the corridors of Parliament, a new vigour in the voices of those who've been fighting Maastricht. The flak is coming from both sides. On the left, the former socialist minister, Jean-Pierre Chevènement, declaring the whole treaty needs to be renegotiated at summit level, while critics on the right declare Maastricht
is,
dead.
Possible. I think it is a pity to have the Denmark out, but I understand the Danish people and their vote because of the treaty is not a good treaty. My wish would be that the renegotiation is the occasion to change the treaty.
President Mitterrand's decision to risk a referendum is a reflection of the strength of anti-Maastricht feeling that his government has encountered. He has, after all, long been one of the treaty's chief champions. His gamble is that the French people share his dream of European Union and will silence those who believe Maastricht can now be unraveled.
There is no treaty of Maastricht anymore. History has passed it by. It is therefore necessary to renegotiate a new treaty. And then, I hope it's negotiated by listening to John Major rather than Jacques Delors.
John Major will have the job of sorting all this out when Britain takes over the presidency of the community at the end of this month. At the moment, it does seem that 11 governments are determined to find some way of going ahead without Denmark, anxious to avoid at all costs another round of painful and difficult negotiations. But critics of Maastricht see this as an opportunity to reopen the debate. No surprise, perhaps, that that's happening in Britain. Much more significant that it's happening in France, which was such a driving force behind the whole Maastricht process. Edward Sturton, News at 10, Paris.
They began talking officially at the Earth Summit in Rio today in an atmosphere charged with controversy. United Nations Secretary General Boutros Ghali set the tone for the biggest ever gathering of world leaders with the grim observation that the Earth is sick and in danger. Alistair Stewart joins us now live from Rio.
The official opening of the Earth Summit in the hall behind me conjured up a striking mixture of fine words but harsh realities. I heard presidents, prime ministers, even a king say they were here to save the planet. But virtually everyone I spoke to remained fixed on the nagging question, how much will that cost and who will pay? America's delegation leader William Riley, administrator of the US Environmental Protection Agency, warned that his government wasn't planning any big cash handouts. That, despite a plea from Gro Harlem Brundtland, the former Norwegian premier whose report led to this summit, that the peace dividend should fund environmental protection. She said that was the only security that mattered now. It was a plea that fell on deaf American ears.
The biggest ever summit in history today began its self-allotted task of setting the world on a new course. World leader after world leader warned that to tackle the global crises of poverty, pollution and development, a new political will is demanded and, according to the optimists, will arise.
We are all in this together. No place on the planet can remain an island of affluence in a sea of suffering and misery. We're either going to save the whole world or no part of it will be saved.
We are the children.
For our children and grandchildren's sake, they urged as great an investment in the environment as in defense in the past.
A sharp reduction in the arms race and the expected peace dividend can be used to finance today's most urgent form of collective security, environmental security.
But even as delegates digested this morning's speeches, it was becoming transparently obvious that this summit is all about one thing, money. Put simply, the Third World wants much more aid from the rich.
We cannot save the environment if the rich refuse to provide greater aid to the poor.
Today, the rich gave their answer. Maybe, but not much.
It has always seemed to me a mistake to characterize this conference as a major moment of North-South commitments. Our own budgetary situation and that of many other developed countries simply does not permit that, realistically.
Later, Mr. Riley told me, under no circumstances would the Americans sign the crucial biodiversity convention to protect animal and plant species.
I do not myself foresee any circumstances under which we would revisit our position on the current language in the Biological Diversity Convention.
The North-South conflict that everyone predicted is unfolding before our eyes. The conference hall has become a battleground between apparently irreconcilable opposing views. Lawrence McGuinty, News at 10, Rio de Janeiro.
You can't appreciate the size and range of this Earth Summit from the conference hall alone. Here are some of the images I've seen.
Many thousands of trees laid down their lives so the events here could be chronicled. 7,000 journalists chasing 10,000 delegates, every word finding an audience. The frenetic search for the story, though, leads some up televisual dead ends. Some prefer the old ways, a postcard of Brazil for the folks back home in Japan. The global message hits you from every angle, though the symbols are often quirky. I've seen models of a brave new world, cookers that fry by the heat of the sun. It can work, the message is it must work. Children here seem to have grasped it already. We'll know by next weekend whether their elders have as well.
Just a flavour of some of the other images of the Earth Summit. And with that, it's back to Trevor in London.
And we'll have more on the Rio Summit after the break, with a report from Denver, Colorado, a city which should have all the attributes of the American dream. But Denver is slowly strangling itself through pollution and conspicuous overconsumption. Can Mr. Bush defend Denver in Rio? A special report next. Plus, tributes for the self-confessed snob of English theatre and films. And Leicester's dream of a 10th Derby win disappears at Epsom. That's in a couple of minutes.
The new Peugeot 106, already voted small hatchback of the year. The legendary Peugeot 205. Over 4 million customers know why. And the remarkable Peugeot 405, with its unique ICD road handling system. All part of the winning formula from Peugeot, which is why the Lion continues to go from strength to strength.
Entertaining can sometimes be a bit of a drag. That's why I insisted on a new gas built-in oven. Okay, Jonathan, pizzas are ready. It's got a ceramic grill, which means you have a large area to cook with. On the outside, it stays cool, and on the inside, it helps clean itself. Unlike this lot. But the best thing is, it has a fan-assisted oven, which gives it an even temperature throughout. Don't you just love being in control?
There was a little girl
who had a little curl, right in the middle of her forehead. And when she was good, she was very, very good. But when she was bad, she was horrid.
Horribly good colour from New Gold 2, Kodak's best ever colour film. Kodak, the colour of life.
Who cares if you can't have that Italian designer dress because of your passion for Italian food?
Ooh.
Who cares if your good intentions go to pot because you can't resist desserts? Who cares if popping out for a sandwich means piling on the calories? Who cares enough to come up with Shapers, calorie-counted foods that taste anything but? Who cares?
Any old iron, any old iron, any old iron, it's gotta be right with Amorite on iron, on iron.